with me, please. And to introduce to you and to present to others our messenger for tonight, Pastor Shirley Polk Davis from the Greater Gospel Temple Church of Praise and Worship. And as I've said, I've met her before, and we had a great time with her that evening. She's going to come and give you what the Lord has given to her.
Amen.
Amen.
Father, in your hand I commend my spirit.
Yes.
But that wasn't the end. Glory. That was just the beginning.
All right.
You got to look at us right here.
Now. All right now.
Say a wonder about Jesus.
Yes.
Wonder in my soul.
Yes, it is.
Anything that we need.
My Lord.
Anything that we've ever needed.
Yes.
Anything that we will need in the future.
Glory.
Is all in him.
Yes,
because
Lord.
He has told us that he's going to supply
Jesus
all I need.
Amen.
According to his riches,
yes,
in glory,
mm-hmm,
by Christ Jesus.
Oh,
you know, the disciple, the Paul, the apostle, they told us all of this.
Amen.
If our ways please him,
if
he'll give us the desires of our hearts.
Oh, yes.
Why? Because Jesus came down,
yes,
and he was the redeemer for our sin.
Yes, Lord.
If it had not been for the Lord on our side,
yes,
where would we be?
Jesus.
Would we even be in existence?
My
because
Lord.
The world was in such horrible, terrible, terrible shape to nothing. No goats,
my
no
Lord.
Sheep,
yes.
Nothing could take the place in
yes.
that sin.
Oh, yeah.
No.
That's why God said, going down there myself,
uh-huh,
and see about my children.
Yes.
And he came down here, hallelujah, woo, and I can stand and say, hallelujah, thank you, God,
for
salvation. And we talk about the story in this Passion of the Christ movie. I did not watch it until maybe a couple of years ago because I never really wanted to watch it. I didn't have the urge to watch it.
Well,
yes.
Well.
So I finally watched it. And I said, no. That's just too much.
Well,
they put too much into it.
Mm-hmm.
Then I went to the scripture,
mm-hmm,
and I said, no, they really didn't describe what they did to Jesus.
Well,
he was unrecognizable,
yes,
as
yes,
a man.
My
they
God.
Had brutalized him,
yes,
and beat him so much.
Oh, yes.
It was worse than the movie itself.
Yeah, worse.
But you know what? Because of me,
yes,
little old me,
well,
he took all of that,
yeah,
just so that I could be saved.
Glory,
just
glory.
A little old me.
Yeah.
Jesus loved me so much,
yes,
that he did it for me.
Yes.
He did it for you.
Glory.
He didn't regret it.
Yes.
He never regrets it.
Yes.
But you know what God said? All souls are mine.
Yes.
And the soul that sinneth, it shall die.
Yes.
So we have the right to the tree of life.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
We have the gift of salvation.
Glory.
Yes.
We know the scriptures. And he said if we obey him, we will be saved. And we will make it into,
mm-hmm,
the kingdom of God. But if we continue in sin,
yes,
we
yes.
will see the second death.
Yes.
And what is the second death? That's hell.
Hell.
The second death.
Yes.
There's no way out.
Glory.
He came and paved the way so we
yes.
wouldn't have to see that terrible, terrible, terrible tossing and rolling
yeah,
and
yeah.
hollering and screaming
mm-hmm.
and burning and burning and worms in the skin.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Just hollering. And this lasts forever and ever
yeah.
and ever
yes.
and ever.
Yes.
So he
yes.
said,
right.
I'm going and I'm going to make a way for you.
Mm-hmm.
But they can have eternal life.
Oh, yes.
And they can live forever and ever and
mm-hmm.
ever and ever.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, there is a, and even he said, we can walk on the gold.
Yeah,
come on now.
Elder Davis, my husband, he had gold in his mouth. And he said, if I can eat on it, I can sure walk on it. He said that the streets are paved with gold. And there's so shiny and they're so slick till they look
yes.
like they're transparent.
Yes, mm. yes.
But it's gold.
Gold.
And then there are 12 foundations.
My Lord.
It's shaped like a cube. Mm-hmm. And there's room enough for every last one of us. He
yes.
said, I'm coming back.
Yes.
He said, I'm going to prepare a place
yes.
for you.
Yes.
And then I'm going to come back
all right.
myself and receive you. So that's a personal thing.
Yes,
he loves
is.
Us so much
yes.
that he's gone and preparing the place for us.
Oh, yes.
And then he himself is going to come down here and get us
yes.
himself.
Yes.
That's love.
Glory.
I am so thankful to God for everything that I've heard,
mm-hmm.
everything that's going forward. To Pastor Polk, thank you so much for the invitation. It's such a wonderful, wonderful thing. I am so humbled when people ask me to speak or just take part in a program or something that's going on. It humbles me because I want people to know that I can live the same life. God saved me. I wasn't doing a whole lot of things like people say, but hey, I wasn't saved, so it doesn't make any difference. All right. I could have been the worst criminal in the world.
Yes.
I could have been just as good as I wanted to be.
Yes.
They could say, oh, that's the best person, what they say, the best person I ever seen in my life, but if I had not repented of myself,
I would have
been the worst person in this world.
Yes.
So this is serious business.
Yes, it is.
Do we really understand what Jesus went through and why he went through?
Yes.
And the basic thing is it for us.
Yes.
We can all take it personally.
Lord,
he loved us so much that he said, I'm going to go and shed the blood for those sinful, wicked, evil folks down there. But because I made them, I've given them a chance. After chance, they killed thousands of sheep, thousands of oxen. Put that blood out on the altar. I accepted that. I didn't like it. But that was the only thing that I could do for them to cover their sin at the time. Even though they still acted among us. But because I love them so much, I'm going to give myself a body. And I'm going down there and I'm going to suffer. All of that. He knew before he came what he was going to say.
Yes,
he knew the degree of what it was going to be, the pain, the suffering, the bloodshed, the beating him, the making fun of him, ridiculing him, saying all kinds of crazy things to him. And it was all because of jealousy, envy. These people did not like what he had to say, like so many times they don't like what we have to say.
All right.
We got to tell the truth.
Yes.
No matter where we are, what we do, where we go, whatever, we got to tell the truth. And while we're telling the truth, we got to live the
life. Live it.
We can tell the truth, but if we don't live the life, it's all in vain. We've got to do what the Lord has told us to do. We've got to honor his death, his burial, and the resurrection. We've got to abide by the rules and regulations that God has set in this book. Let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place. That's where we are right now. That's why we're honoring him right now. Because he has gone to prepare that place. And there will be no evil in that place. They won't have to shut the gates like lock our gates. We have to lock our doors. We have to lock our cars. We have to lock everything else. But nothing evil will enter in. And then if we feel a little queasy, there's a tree, he said. Just reach up and take a leaf off of it. And take a little taste off of it. And we'll be all right. We'll be good to go. Isn't that wonderful?
Prepared
for us. All we have to do is live the life.
Live
the life and remember what he has done for us. What he has done for us. Remember what he has done for us. It was horrible. It was terrible. We don't have to go through it.
That's right.
He went through it for us. We do have to live the life that he said for us to live. We've got to be holy. We've got to be holy. If you're not holy, you're not going to make it into the kingdom of God. We will be judged by what we do. Down here.
Yes.
Thank you, God bless. Amen.